Welcome to Amnesty TV. Stay tuned to find out what this man is doing, why comedian Romesh Ranganathan took all his clothes off, and why this Saudi woman has no arms.
It's quiz time. Last month, Burma's most famous comedian, Zarganar, told reporters he isn't happy. Is this because A. his TV show has been cancelled? B. he has been arrested for criticising the government? C. he has been sentenced to 59 years in prison? Or D. he has just been released from prison?
A recent survey apparently showed that 54% of people in this country are in favour of the death penalty. And do you know how many people they asked? 1,100. 54% of that figure is 594. Those 594 people really need to take a look at themselves. That's right, I'm about to lay the smackdown on nearly 600 people. I mean, like, not literally. That'd be kind of defeating the whole object. I mean verbally, of course. Let's have a look at some of the arguments. The argument that many supporters of the death penalty put forward is that we should punish taking a life by taking a life. What you're essentially saying is, you've committed murder, murder is wrong, we need to show you that murder is wrong, and the way that we're going to do that is to murder you. And surely if you're going to use this as a basis of a fair legal system, what you really need to do is extend it to every single crime and not just murder. Are you going to mug a mugger?
It's time for justice!
Are you going to flash a flasher?
It's time for justice!
And what if someone commits insider trading? Another argument put forward by proponents of the death penalty is that it's a strong deterrent. Anne Widdecombe recently stated that we'd have a much more effective legal system if the law was tougher. I think Anne Widdecombe's support of the death penalty is one of the strongest possible arguments against it. Are people really suggesting that we feel free to kill in this country because there is no death penalty? Surely we should be inundated with immigrant murderers looking to take advantage of our lax regulations on killing. In the US, the states that have the death penalty typically have a higher murder rate than those without. Perhaps that's because by sanctioning murder, we're actually undermining the value of human life. It's like how I can't watch ballroom dancing anymore, ever since I saw Anne Widdecombe murdering the art form on Strictly Come Dancing. If only the judges were tougher on her. In the state of Illinois, where the murder rate per capita is much higher than it is here in the UK, they've recently abolished the death penalty because no legal system could ever guarantee that no innocent person would ever be put to death. Reinstating the death penalty, despite having a flawed system, is a little bit like saying you want to conduct heart surgery, despite the fact your hands get a little bit shaky when you see blood. In conclusion, how can we really consider ourselves a civilised society while sanctioning murder? Thank you very much for listening. I'm off to explain this another 594 times.
As a woman living in Saudi Arabia, do you often worry that you are about to be a victim of state brutality? Well, worry no more. This educational video will help. How not to get punished for being a woman. The first thing you need to understand is, as a woman, you are the property of a man, either your father, brother, or your husband. This man is your guardian. It's his job to look after you, and it's your job to do exactly what he says. Follow these simple tips, and you will be fine. Study and work. Ask your guardian if you can go to school. Fingers crossed, he'll say yes. You'll learn how to perform your primary role in life, which is to be an ideal housewife and a good mother. You can also train to be a teacher or a nurse. But remember, ask permission from your guardian unless you want to be punished. Movement. A woman's place is in the home. A man's place is everywhere else. Here are some simple do's and don'ts to help you to remember. Walking from the kitchen to the bedroom? Yes. Boarding a plane on your own? No. Walking from the bedroom to the bathroom? Yes. Driving a car? No. Walking from the bathroom to the bedroom? Yes. Taking public transport? No. Remember, ask permission unless you want to be punished. health. Medical emergency, your instinct might be to call your doctor or rush to the hospital. Stop. Your doctor cannot treat you without your guardian say so. Remember, ask permission unless you want to be banished. Other stuff. Here is a load of other things that you shouldn't do. Don't catch a train with men. Don't go to offices with men. Don't go to restaurants with men. Don't go to beaches, amusement parks, or ice skating rinks with men. Don't play sport. Don't attempt to speak in court. So here is a quick recap. You must get permission if you ever want to study, work, travel, see the doctor, or use the law. Remember. Ask permission unless you want to be punished.
It's quiz time. The answer is D. Zarganar is unhappy because he has just been released from prison. Zarganar was one of more than 200 political prisoners released recently, leaving around 2,000 still in jail. Zarganar says, "I will be happy and thank the government only when all my friends are freed." Zarganar has been off air for a while. He was banned from performing and in 2008 got a 59-year prison sentence, later reduced to 35 years, for complaining about government inefficiency. Zarganar is now off on tour, visiting Burma's jails with gifts for the prisoners.
Sunshine, lollipops and wings.